All right, hello everyone. Let's check everything works correctly. Yeah, I guess everything is online. All right, so my name is Gaëtan Renaudot, and in this live stream, I'm writing some shaders. So shaders are animations. Some programs that runs in a GPU and where you can generate a lot of nice graphics and every day I've been writing some shaders to do a bunch of different effects, a bunch of different patterns, some remarching, some retracing of 3D scenes. And yeah, a bunch of experiments. And the goal is for me to explore something different every day. So I'm also the author of GL React. And today I've released a new version of GL React, the V5, that now supports WebGL 2. So it's a big step for this library. And essentially, it was not that it was actually really close to be able to support it. So it was about supporting GL ES3. So there is a new version of the GLSL language in that version that allows us to do a bunch of more interesting things, like for instance the one I've shared here. So we were actually stuck in the past on some shaders on this problem with the fact you cannot do loops with variables in the loop. I mean you have to statically have a constant to that's a limitation of the V1 of the GLES 1 and with the V3 or at least I think from the V2. They allowed to have non-constant expressions in for loops. So you can do while loop, you can do much of more interesting things. And that's typically for the remarcher, we could have a parameter of the function, of the remarch function. It could be a parameter, like the limit could be a parameter, where in the past you would have to hard code it. So yeah, pretty important. But at the end, you better want to have for loops that finish, because at the end it runs on the GPU, so you must finish. In any case, in the past days, I've been working on a bunch of things. I've also received a bunch of nice books about patterns that maybe I can explore today. I don't know. I never know in advance what I'm gonna do. So it's a bit exploratory. It's a bit fun in that I don't really know where I'm going, but I'm trying to reach a goal, and then I see where I go with that. But in the previous. Previous days, shader days, I've been working on a few things, patterns, some patterns, and things around chess. So I've been day after day modelizing some chess pieces, and I've been doing this day after day. So every time I was introducing a new piece, and maybe I'm gonna do that today. I'm gonna finish all the pieces because I only miss one piece. So yeah, we'll see about that. Maybe I can start as a Kickstarter with that idea because it's a goal. It's an easy goal to reach. So I think I'm gonna do that. So anyway, today it's Shader Day. So it's Saturday, it's Shader Day. So that's the point of this live stream, is to every week do a little status update on the live coding regarding shaders, because I do it every day anyway, one per day. But this day is a bit special because I'm gonna also live stream it. All right. So I don't know if this is okay, but I'm gonna put some music. Maybe it's not gonna be hearable from you. Anyway, let's start with something. So before we do anything, I think I'm gonna start with the basic template. That's what I'm having here. So we have a UV parameter. We even have the time here. So this is a varying. It's varying because it varies for each main iteration. So actually, this was in ES1 that you would have to write varying, and you would have to set a color as an output. But now we have a better. So to enable the version 3 of ES, you have to. Of GLSL, you have to do that. And now if I save that, it's gonna tell me varying is no longer, basically is no longer working like that. It's still a reserved keyword, but I'm not sure it's actually used anymore. You have to just say in, so it's an input. It's much better now, it's much, much more clear. And as an output, you give a color. And the color is a RGBA vector, so it's a vector. Where before it was implicitly defined as that, but now I can set to whatever name I want and just do that. So just to be clear, here we are just doing that. That's the most basic shader basically, except okay, we have the time, maybe we can take the fractional part of the time, move from 0 to 1 and put that in green. In blue, RGB, so in the blue component. So here it's pretty clear that we take as an input a UV position, and as an output we have to set a color. That's what we do in the main function that is called for each pixels of my canvas. So it's pretty straightforward, and with the new version of GL, WebGL 2, which allows to do GLSL 3, yes. We can do that much more clearly, I think. It's much more straightforward and on top of allowing a lot of more things, but that's a nice start. So anyway, we are going to try to progress on our chess, I guess. So I'm gonna... So what do we have in chess? We have six different pieces. If we look at the chess pieces, okay. Yeah, so we have the king, the queen, the rook, bishop. So bishop is the one I don't have yet. A knight and pawn, and we can see the scale, I mean the height of each piece is going up, and the way I have encoded that is like it's from 0 to 5 in the order we have here. So anyway, we can take a look at the code I had so far. So I think last time was here. I was playing with some wood textures to make the pieces look even better. Yeah, I guess I can take that again as a starting point. Seems like my computer is lagging a bit. Alright, so let's check what we have here. All right, so in this shader, I actually wrote a knight, the knight piece, and it's made out of I think 4 or 5 parts, and just applying some union soft, so like smoothing between the pieces, between the different essentially different boxes, you actually make that shape. I had also to remove a sphere for making the eye and another sphere that is a bit stretched to make the mouth. But basically, it's pretty simple stuff. It's just a few shapes, and that's what I've been doing. So, what's a bit annoying about this shader, by the way, is it takes a few seconds to compile, and this is actually happening because I have a bunch of ifs. If we look somewhere, I think below. Not this one, but yeah, for making the moves, I haven't really figured out a math formula to express that based on I. So I made a bunch of ifs, and this is pretty costly for the GPU to compile. And I clearly notice it, so yeah, could be improved. But in my case, I'm gonna drop a bunch of things. And just gonna focus on the bishop. So what does this do? Yeah, I think we can drop that. And then maybe I don't know if I had some special lighting just for this, just for my demo here, but. I can undo that anyway, if I find some other things to undo. Okay, so I guess we are good. We can see some shade. So the shading, like the coloring of the 3D objects is done here. And for a given hit, so what I call the hit is a given position, like when we do the remarching from the camera, we are throwing rays, and as soon as it hits a 3D object, that's a hit. And in that information, this is just an alias for VEC4, because I have to store a bunch of things. First of all, there is the X, which is the distance with the camera. Then there is a Y, which is a material, like an identifier, a number. And then I use the X and the Z to express some X and Y coordinates on my 3D objects. It's a bit weird, but since we cannot do VEC5, I use that technique. But I think I could make a struct to store all the data I want, because essentially I need the local position of my object in the global positioning. This allows me to do texturing on the pieces, and when the pieces are moving, I actually can skip the same mapping, because if we take a look at the texture, it's just a 2D texture of wood, and I'm gonna map that in 3D. So that's what this logic is doing here. Here we have some lighting. So I think I just have I have 3 lights right now, but I think I can drop one and see later if I need really 3 lights. I can make that lighter. All right, so I have a yellow-red line light and a bluish light here. So that's compensate a bit. So we have one side that is a bit red and one side that is a bit blue. It's quite interesting when you have shadows, but right now I just have one shadow from only one side. So yeah, we'll see about that. We'll see what we can polish. And this is a remarcher, so I'm gonna switch I think I have a bunch of utilities in this part as well. I use a lot of cones. I think it's not that efficient to do all of that, but I use a bunch of cones for making my pieces. I think it makes sense. I'm not really sure what other primitives I could. Without that, I don't really see what how to achieve everything I did. All right, so I'm gonna switch to GLSL3, and this means this is an input, and we have a color output. If I call it color, yeah, I guess it's gonna be fine. All right, so there's a few changes. It's no longer texture 2D. It's actually texture 3, just texture. I think we can do 3D textures now. I think that's just one. All right, so let's save that. And it works again. I have no idea if it's more performant or whatever. I didn't really check that. I'm a bit curious. Anyway, let's dive into trying to make a 3D shape now. So I have just the chessboard now. And I'm gonna take a look at what the bishop looks like. So I have a... All right, so yeah, this is a simple one. I don't know if you can see it here, yeah. So it's pretty simple. There is different versions of it. Every chess, I guess, are a bit unique. But, I think I will make some variants of the chess, like different version of chess. Different designs, but this one is a simple one, and I'm gonna just try to make the same. So it's pretty straightforward to do. I think it's not gonna take that long. We can definitely see there is a cone. To me, there is going to be a cone, and maybe another cone here, and then it's just some circles. So let's try that. All right. I'm just gonna disable that. All right. So let's try to make the bishop. Where is it? So I have a function, yeah, here, that is doing a mapping for a given ID. It's gonna pick the correct function, and I had commented that one, so this is not defined yet. I'm not sure what I should pick as a starting point. Maybe a pawn. I'm just gonna put one piece in the middle to see what I'm doing. So let's see. S equal. Let's see. I think I'm gonna put the queen. All right, so this is returning a float, and what I need is something that returns me a hit, because I have to give more information. So I think that's why I have a piece function that is a bit higher level, and what I give in that is the position of my array. Then I have to give a number, which is the ID of the piece, and then I have to say if it's a white or a black piece. So here, I don't know what I did, but doesn't seem to render anything. So I guess this is because it's probably in a corner. Because here, I offset my position to make it from 0 to 7, I guess. So I'm gonna put the Y at 4, and then I'm gonna offset. I think I need to... I need to remove because the ray is moving, not the piece. All right, what's going on here? Oh yeah, it's actually Z. All right, so we have our. It's not a queen. It's the king. But yeah, I guess it's okay. Where is my yeah? So I think it's slightly smaller, the bishop. But it looks like more. Looks like a pawn in a way, just higher. Anyway, I think I can do. I can put a king on the right and a pawn on the left. So what I can do is, I guess move by one. Yeah, something like that is okay. And my bishop is going to be 12. So here it's not gonna appear because I didn't define it yet. All right, so let me check something. I think I need to stop making my camera move because it's not gonna be useful for now. I can just position myself somewhere. Like that. All right, so why is it like that? Yeah, I think it needs to be 2 or something. And so for developing my shapes, what I did is making an orthogonal projection instead of a perspective camera. I use an orthogonal one, and then I can actually literally put my piece on my screen and see if it matched. Right now it's a bit small, so maybe I can adjust a bit that. In any case, I guess we are good. All right, let's start to do something. Let's try it out. Let's define our bishop, and I'm gonna fork the function for the pawn. So it's a sine distance function, meaning it gives the distance to the closest object. So for my, like in the 3D scene, for a given point, I'm gonna give the distance to my object, to my bishop. So I just combine a bunch of operations, a bunch of primitives, doing some operation between them. So here we have a sphere, I guess that's that sphere here. We have a cone, and we have a bunch of discs, like we can see here. So I don't know what's going on with the base, but it looks real. Maybe it's because of my remarcher. Anyway, so what's the size? What is the size? What size do I need? I think it needs to be a bit bigger than the rook. Yeah. All right. So I guess this is moving up. The piece. I'm actually moving down, yeah, indeed. Right now. I think we can, if I take a quick look here on my piece, it's more or less that size, and then I just need to, I guess, to put that here. So this, the cone is going to grow. Okay, so what did we do here? Okay, so I guess I still need to do that. That's weird. Oh, I was offsetting here as well, so and indeed my base need to change, so I think we can press 6. Well, it takes some time to redraw, I don't know why. I think I can remove one, like remove the pawn. Something is quite slow. Maybe I have too much primitives now. I'm gonna undo all of them and comment those I don't need. What was that? Right, that's okay. I guess the knight is quite a lot of code. Yeah, and also the rook. So I think I'm reaching a point where the things are starting to get slow to render, to compile mostly, I think, and that's pretty bad. But yeah, that's why you try to optimize, trying to use as less primitives as possible, because you want to keep the most simple formula, math formula for the GPU. Otherwise, if you do a lot of code or a lot of ifs, it's gonna be quite heavy for the GPU to upload. All right, so what's going on here? Okay, so I don't know why I'm having this weird disk here, but I guess that was for the pawn anyway. In my case, I still have a disk, but it's not really here. I think it can be a bit higher. And also the base is pretty weird, to be honest. I think it's due to that. And yeah, I guess the size is wrong. So first of all, what my cone is, is it good? It's a bit weird, I think. I think it's too high now. Maybe if I... Not really like that, but... Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I think I will need to have a big... like this parameter needs to increase, so it can do a nice soft with whatever is above it. And indeed we have some kind of sphere, but this is not gonna be enough. Let's see. So I think if I lower a bit my sphere, I can do that shape. So I need to work on my head first of all. So my head is gonna be a sphere, an union of two spheres, and this is going to be here. So I think we have a small sphere and a big one. And then we need to offset it properly, so I think we can do that. Yeah, it's too low now, but I think I can adjust that a bit. All right, so it's okay. Yeah, I think something like, oops, not that. I'm trying to think because the shape looks like a cone at the end. But the cone is a bit ghosty, so I think I need to union soft here. And here I need to stretch a bit. So let's see. I think I need to zoom to see what I do because it's quite small. I mean, we don't need to be pixel perfect anyway. We can do more or less a good thing. I think right now it's pretty good. I just want to stretch a bit more that part. So let's see. So I have a big sphere. Let's start with a big sphere. Like a really big sphere. So to stretch it like on the Y, I just need to multiply by a value higher on the Y. So yeah, that's what the kind of thing I want. And yeah, I think a factor of 3 is good. And then we just downsize it. And yeah, I think we need to increase that to find a good, yeah, we need to find a good value of that. It's quite long to tweak, like every time, taking a lot of time to try to tweak that. But yeah, the thing I don't really like in my current version is that it's definitely a sphere here, where in the actual shape, it looks like more bigger on the bottom. But actually, to solve that, I could do an union of two spheres. Or actually, I can do the same technique here. I can stretch and do some soft union. Yeah, I think I can try that. But then I need to move down a bit more and probably less. Yeah, I don't know. Not really. It's not touching yet. Oh, that's quite interesting. Why is it actually even growing the top part? What I can do is another like I can do a disc. I should have done a disc, not a sphere. I think a disc is even more efficient. It's taking too much time. It's taking me too much time to do what I want to do. All right, so what do we have here? I think it looks a bit better, a bit closer to what I wished. To try to have as a shape. So yeah, definitely we have our shape now, but I think we can increase that now. That's interesting. So I'm not gonna spend too much time on that part anyway, on the head part. It's okay now. I think it's good. Can increase a bit the smoothing. All right, so what I need to do is raise that disc a bit more. Now we have the union with the body part, which also is interesting, but it looks already quite okay. I don't want to put it too much because then we have that, and actually I don't think I need to do anything now on that part because I can just do that and then add a bunch of discs. If you have any question, by the way, feel free to ask, and I can pause and explain a bit better things, how it works and everything. But yeah, essentially, we have a bunch of primitives, and we are doing some math with them, like the distance with my ray, and using some min, some max, which produce some union intersections. We can do things like that, and indeed, with the head, we forgot to do to cut the bishop. And it's pretty straightforward. It's not a sphere, it's actually just a box that we cut, and I'm gonna try that right now. So we take our head, and then we to remove an object from another, it's actually the max distance between your object and minus the distance of the object you remove. So in my case, I'm gonna remove something from the head, and this is going to be a box. So I think we have somewhere above, I think we have F box. Oh, okay, my computer is quite slow because it's encoding the stream, and I guess with the shader it doesn't help. I have a warning about that. F box P and the size of my box. So let's try something. All right, so indeed our boxes is a why is it doing that? Why is there a sphere here? I don't really know. Oh, I guess that's the cone, because I remove from the head. So our box needs to be positioned, and so I need to, I will call it cut, and to actually see what I'm doing, I'll just return the cut. Because I need to position it properly. So here we have a cube. What we need is to stretch it and rotate. But so I'm gonna make a Q variable. We have a way to rotate something with a PR function that is just doing some trigonometry, some cosinus and sinus, to do a basic rotation here. And you give it a plan to rotate. In my case, the plan is here, so we actually rotate on the Z axis. So the plan is XY, and we give some angle. So I don't know. I don't know what. Okay, so that's moving like that. So I guess I can rotate a bit. So maybe 0.2. I don't know what the angle is, but something. It's not in degree. It's in radian. So whatever is this angle, it's a bit more. I don't know, we can try that. But then we need to give a different X coordinate. So I think it's here. All right, so we need to cut with that essentially. And it looks okay so far. I think it's even almost positioned correctly. So let's see, and then we can tweak the positioning. Not really. I guess we can move it a bit left. So to do that, I think I need to move before. Yeah. Perfect. That looks exactly like what I have right now. Yeah, except the top of the head is pretty weird. I think I need to stretch it a bit more. Where is it? Oh, it's not stretch. It's just a disc. Oh, it's just that precise, it's weird. Okay, I think I just can tweak that. Yeah, but then it's not doing that. It's okay, I mean, we don't need to be pixel perfect. I'm just a bit worried about the shape here. It does not look like it's symmetric, the head, but it's a bit flat on the top. I think that's why maybe we should have kept our sphere. And I mean, the sphere like that is gonna be awful, but I can multiply like before. So when you remove something from a SD object, you're actually making it grow, because you remove some of your distance, so the object is actually closer to your ray, and that's actually growing your object. So it's a pretty nice trick. Yeah, okay, so it's a bad idea. I don't know why the disk is working a lot better with the UnionSoft, but I'm gonna keep that. That's the effect I want. It's okay if it's not perfect. I could merge it with a sphere to make, if I want to have some kind of peak on the top, but I don't have that, so it's okay. I'm gonna move on to a bunch of other disks. Moving that up a bit, so if we add 0.3, we remove here. Then we move that up, but actually I'm gonna move it quite a lot. So I think I did that. Okay, so we have a first positioning here, which is too high. Actually it's good. We don't have our base anymore. What's happening here? I think everything is a bit offset. Where is this going? Like, this is wrong. What did I do? Alright, so I don't know why. I think I got something wrong here. Anyway, we can fix that later. Yeah, it's almost good, but in any case, we first need to place correctly the part above, which means, yeah, I think my head is too low. Do I have the correct sizing when I compare like that? Yeah. I don't know what size should I. Yeah, I think that's like that. Alright, so here I have a bunch of disks. Actually, I have two disks which are a bit symmetrical, but I guess what I can do is split this in two parts. Do one, two, one, two. It's almost the same. And then why am I not seeing anything here? I don't know. Oh yeah. So D, I have a D variable here that I use to accumulate my distance, but I don't really use it properly. Body is the head plus, yeah, I think I can do D. What's going on here? What? So yeah, I think I'm not doing what I want to do. The disc is not like a column. It's not like a. This is really a hack here to do that, because it's not gonna grow. It's gonna grow like that, and in my case, I'm not sure I want that. But maybe I can trick something like that. So this is useless. Like, this is pointless to that. It's actually a sphere at that point. Oh, that's not. I mean, I can just pile a bunch of discs one on top of the other. So let's start with us. A small one. So let's see. Where should I be here? I guess point one. No. Okay, just here. I think I can do a soft union of two things, because when you look at that code, it's not so crazy. It's just a bunch of absolute, max, min, and some basic stuff. So it's pretty cheap, I think. Alright, so let's see. What just happened? Where is that? Oh, I'm not using that at all, so yeah, indeed. Oh, it's actually growing. Yeah, it's not the effect I want, to be honest. But I guess this will make it. Maybe I should lower that. Yeah, because of the cone, this looks bigger than the one under it. But actually, it can be a bit bigger on both sides, and then I can just play with that parameter. It's quite aggressive, this parameter. I think I can. Yeah, I don't need to be that close. I mean, actually, I need to be closer. But then Yeah, this is so hard to tweak. It's just a small effect. I don't know where I'm going with all of this stuff. It's quite interesting that the soft is not working when I don't have any wire. I think I'm overthinking it right now. So what I'm gonna do is just improvise a bit. Instead of doing that, I'm just gonna put a sphere. Like that. And then we have a disc, and that's it. I think I should switch to the chess channel on Twitch. All right, I think that's it. The body, I don't really like my body right now. Like here, it's not enough curvy. It's quite a cone. But I think we can arrange that by doing some soft union. Where is it defined? The sphere, the disc is here. No, so here we have our base. It's not well positioned, by the way. I think it needs to be lower. Yeah, like that. I like it. Where is our or cone? I don't see it. Ah, here. So this is our body. Okay, so we put with the head. I don't like what I'm gonna do. I don't think it's gonna work. I think it's gonna mess with the head. Yeah, it's not gonna work like that. And it's not even changing my curve at all. Only the head is changing. I don't know if I switch the parameters, is it doing the same thing? Oh yeah, because I changed that. Yeah, I guess that's symmetrical. All right, our body. If I put the subhead with the head, maybe that helps. No. What's going on if I do that? Nothing. Yeah, it's not doing anything that I want. So I think we will keep that as is. Maybe playing with the bass, but I think I'm already doing that. No, oh no, man. Yeah, there is something into that. I think that's an idea. if maybe by changing the cone. What? Oh no, that's not here. Here. Yeah, but the thing is, it's weird now. Oh, this is so bad. No. Alright, we are good. So now we are going to look at that in 3D. So I'm disabling my orthogonal camera. And I'm gonna move my camera around. So where is it centering at zero? So I guess I can move. Oh, what's going on here? The head is not touching. I think I messed up with my Rem Archer now. Maybe I need more iterations, but 20, maybe I need to lower a bit the traversal. No, not really helping. I mean, yeah, I can do more iterations, but it's not gonna solve the issue. So I think we can see that something is wrong with my head. Wrangle tout aussi. I think we can close that part. We are good. So let's try to continue that experiment. And what should we do? I guess we can. Try to make all the pieces in a board, and that's gonna be the shader of the day. So let's put back everything together and figure out the math for that to try to make it also efficient as much as possible, even though I think by adding that all of these primitives is quite slow to compile, not ready to run at runtime, but I think when I say that, well, yeah, there's no animation, so we cannot see when it refresh, but we'll see quite quickly about that. I think it's gonna be slow to compile. I'm gonna switch another music. Alright, we have our pieces, so we have our board. The board is everything, so our scene is literally just, it's actually a ball, it's actually a sphere, we are inside the sphere, and then you have the board in the middle, and in the board we have the chessboard, and we have the pieces. So first of all, we start by putting the chessboard a bit above and the pieces on top of it. And then we offset our origin to the 0-0. And then we put one after one the pieces. So let's move up. Up. I don't know why I am not centering correctly. I guess that's because I'm not on zero, yeah. Okay, I'm not sure what's going on here. Okay, it doesn't like. The lookat function doesn't like when you are actually at the. Exactly at that. So I think I can tweak with the zoom. So yeah, we can see our pieces here. I think I have something messy with that positioning. Because the zero is not here. The zero should be here. Okay, so it all depends how we want to represent our mapping, our space. But to me, when you look at that, I mean, the zero should be here, and then that's increasing. So yeah, we want to do that. It's okay. We can change the position after. So, in any case, we need to repeat. Our scene into as many positions as there is. So, I will use a repetition operation. So, I think I have up rep something. Or mod. Fmod, I don't know where, what. I think I don't have it here, but I can find it again. Pmod, interval, yeah, this one. Sorry, I was just moving to something, looking at something. Alright, so let's go back to the board. So we use that function, takes a value, and it's doing a modulus on the position, but in an interval between two values. So it's taking the how much, like the interval, and then from the range from 0 to 7. And I think as soon as we have that, I already have it somewhere. So yeah, we don't need to redefine it. So as soon as I have that, I think it should repeat. Okay, it repeats my pieces. So. This is our bishops, but indeed we will want to do that for the pawn rows. But actually, we are going to need to repeat the space on the y as well. And that way, you have your okay, not y because here I'm just piling things. And I want to have some fun around that idea of piling pieces, but that's for later. Okay, so we have the white at the bottom and the black at the top, so that's what we want to do. And then we have to figure out what is the function for getting the type based on the position. So first of all, I don't want these pieces. There's no pieces in these positions. So, what I can do is like the ray, because the ray marcher is throwing a ray, and you can fake, you can trick it by saying, okay, there is an object at 0.5, and then it's the ray is only going to move from 0.5. If you don't do that, I think you can have troubles, you can have glitches. So when there is no pieces, I'm gonna return 0.5 essentially. That said, I think we still need to figure out what is the formula, but let's see. So I don't know how to call that, because piece is already a function. I'm gonna call it A or shape. Alright, so I think I can. I don't want to do ifs, but maybe I have no choices. I'm trying to think. I can mix between two values, between the, a chess piece, or 0.5. And then it's based on something. It's based on, okay, so just hold on, we have an issue here because 0.5 is not a hit, but we can trick that. I think we can trick, we can do something else. Oh, it's actually 9.9. I think we can return 0.5 when the ID is not matching, and that way we actually achieve that by giving a number that does not exist in my mapping. So essentially we need to give a fake value in case there is no pawn, nothing. So we need to determine if it's white. Then we need to determine the ID of the piece. Oh. So that's gonna be fun. So I think we can figure out what the formula is here, but at least we can say that if there is no pieces, I think I'm gonna call that Y. And yeah, we said the X was right, wrong. We have to fix. All right, so it's not inclusive, but yeah, it's inclusive. So zero, if it's zero or one, then we have something. So we multiply by one if Y is below or equal to one. And therefore, this is going to be zero in all the cases there is nothing. So our function above is not gonna enter any ifs, and it's just gonna return 0.5, which allows the ray to progress by 0.5. So what I want indeed is to mean with I think 7 minus y, and then we have these pieces, and then we can say it's pretty straightforward that the white is determined by something like that. It's a hack, it's just for the plotting some like the initial positions. But by the way, we could use a texture to store the information of positioning, and I think if we want to render an actual game, we will just do that and update that texture, and then we just can play any chess game. But in my case, I just want to write some code that will render that, so we have it. And I'm gonna move my camera down. It's not easy to see the big picture with everything. I'm trying to think how I should what kind of animation should I do. I could just rotate, but that's a bit boring. Anyway, it's not really important right now. I need to figure out the formula for the IDs. So 15 is the first range. So I think that means we can say that, and I'm gonna make a y flipped, I mean y a symmetric y, sy, as that, because that's gonna be useful. Everything is symmetrical on the other side, so it's pretty nice. We just need to focus on the white, and what we can say is that, and I'm gonna do like this for now, but if sy is equal to 1, I have my bones. So this number is gonna be funky because I think I can max to make sure nothing goes above that. Yeah, I think I can max between 15 and here I can give any number, it's okay. Mean. Okay, now this is a bit more funky. So our king is here. That's the easy part. But first of all, we need to have a s. So as we said before, I think we need to say that x is actually reversed, because I have something wrong in my I don't know why this is happening, by the way, but it's happening. Oh yeah, because here, and the z axis is no, I don't really get it. Okay, so what is our rook? So king, queen, bishop, knight, rook. I'm gonna keep that in mind. Alright, so there is a symmetry except for the two middle pieces. So based on that fact, I think there is something interesting to do, which is to say that in any case we have to sum with so is this in the correct order? So we have rook, knight, bishop. Yeah, it's perfect, it's just perfectly aligned, except it's reversed. That's the annoying part. So I think I'm gonna change my order just for this, but it's okay. Then it's a max, then we can remove pawns. All right, so now it's pretty straightforward. It's just that SX is gonna determine on the other side. So I think we can just do that. It's just beautiful. Nope. Okay, so I think it was actually in the correct order. So I'm gonna keep that in mind and roll back to do my logic. Queen. All right. Rook, knight, bishop, queen, queen. Okay, so we need to remove for the king. And indeed, it's gonna be okay, so I guess yes, here we go. The simple math formula to determine how the what is the combination, like what is the layout for chess. It's stick in this logic. Can I reduce it though? I think it's okay. And here, we couldn't have done that because we will need to multiply everything. I mean, there is another way we can do is mix. Maybe it makes more sense. I think it's actually smaller to write like that. Yeah, it's much easier to read as well. Okay, but now that's so beautiful. So essentially we mix based on the if it's 0 or 1. So if it's 0, this is the formula for the first line. So this is first line. And then second line is the pawns. Based on that, and then we say, oh, by the way, don't go further than two rows on symmetrically, and this is also symmetric, and everything is symmetrical except the making the distinction between the king and the queen. So my brain is getting slow now. I think I'm gonna stop now. Or maybe 30 more minutes as planned. But we can say this thing has been done now. So 1 hour and a half, not bad. We managed to get the full chess. I mean, I was just missing the bishop, but yeah, managed to also get the pieces placed, and I like to always optimize everything, so I can still tweak that a bit. But yeah, overall we are good. I'm trying to think what kind of animation we should do because this is static, it's boring, nothing is happening. Should I play an opening? I don't know if it should animate the pieces. I don't want to animate the pieces, they are fine. I have some more ideas in the future to achieve that because let's say you like if you want to render an actual game which will be really great, then you also want to animate it. So then I have to give some thought about that. Especially jumping the pieces, what happens when you drop one. I don't want to be too. I'm not making a simulation of chess, just having some fun with some 3D here, so with some math. So I'm maybe will not go that far, but still interesting to think about it. What I definitely want to try is to make another set of pieces, like another design, a bit more cubic, a bit more, I don't know, like low poly, we can see. I had some inspiration from a movie the other day that they were doing using really cubical, like low poly chess, like just a cone, just yeah. It can be interesting to try to imagine different shapes. All right, so I can rotate. That would be a st like I think that would be nice. That would be good enough because at the end we just achieve our first chess, like fully complete chess. Rendering, so that would be an achievement. Yeah, this is so perfect. Like this formula is so great. Like, and from the beginning, I had the correct placement because yeah, I guess on Wikipedia they just give you the order in term of. Oh, actually, I didn't really follow that because King was. Oh yeah, just. To the user direction. King, queen. Oh, actually, I didn't follow that ordering. I think I found. Yeah, I followed that one. Yeah. If you look from the highest to the lowest, and then it's actually the ordering of the pieces. And it looks like my knight is smaller than the rook, by the way. But yeah, it's like by design, I think they may make it going up and down. It's like quite nice looking. But my knight is too small. My knight needs to be a bit bigger. I think I need to tweak that. But I'm not gonna touch that now. It's a bit touchy, the knight shape. I think I need to improve it later. So I'm only having a white and black on a like with some kind of wood texture, and the board is actually having wood. Doesn't have any reflection, doesn't have anything really special about it. Maybe I should try, but I'm a bit worrying about the performances, to be honest. Like when I refresh that page. Yeah, it's quite slow. So I think there's a lot of polish to do on trying to minimize the code, all the math. But here it doesn't look like I can optimize more anyway. It's okay. I think I can just move around. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, first of all, is just a simple rotation. And that's it. I think that's great. We can see a lot of glitches. We can see in the middle, we have some issues with the remarcher. It's reaching its limits. We can see on the king, the cross have issues. I think that's a nice indication that something is wrong about it. Like maybe the formula is not great. Maybe there is a way to improve it. I think I can look into that at some point. What we can tweak to solve these issues is to increase the marcher, because here, if I move by 0.5, and maybe 0.5 is too much, because 0.5 is, it's like the most optimistic thing, because if you are in the middle, it's great, but if you are not in the middle of the square, you are going to have some troubles. You are going to traverse too far, to go too far. So, yeah, I mean, we can still tweak that. We can still try to do 2,200 iterations. It doesn't solve the issue at all. So this actually is okay. The issue is in, I think it's in the 0.5, but if we decrease it, then we will need more iterations, because our ray is going to be slowed down by that part, and that's a bit a problem. And that's caused by the modulus. When you do modulus, everything starts to mess like that. But the benefit is you have great performances versus trying to place one by one, adding one pieces by one. It's making the huge formula, but here with modulus, you just divide your space and you factorize a lot of things. So where is it? Oh, I have a lot of primitives. That's why it's slow. I'm lost. Why do I have that? It's not used. All right, that's here. So if I put 0.1, which is like an extreme idea, we have much more glitches, but we don't have glitches in the middle, or we have a bit on the. We have a bit on the opposite part, but not when you look here, because the rays are thrown from the camera. So as soon as it start progressing on the chessboard, they are not going to traverse far enough. That's why in the middle we have a huge glitch, especially when we are in. Oh, that's not as straightforward as. And here, because I have no pawns, so here we have a lot of 0.1 to traverse, and the ray is not going as far as reaching the background. So that explains it all. But now if I put 0.3, we are almost good, still have a glitch, which means we might need more iterations. But at the same time, if I put 0.4, I start to see some glitches, and even here, yeah, okay, I think we are good. I just need to increase the marching. We can also tweak it here, but I don't think it's going to help. Oh, what's going on with that king? I don't know what's going on with that king. I think it has a. It must have a pretty bad distance estimation. I mean, I'm going crazy here, but like. It doesn't solve at all. Nothing is solved by that. Except that I can just. Alright, so my king is okay when it's close, but when it's too far, it's. I don't know if this is messing things. I have an algorithm here, like there's a technique I've took somewhere that maybe is impacting that. But the precision is going to decrease over time with that technique. But actually, I think it's more helping than creating these issues anyway. So maybe we can increase that. Doesn't help. All right, so this is definitely doing something, but it's not helping the situation about that. I don't know if, yeah, I think we are too. Well, yeah, the king is pretty bad. So maybe we can try to fix that for the 10 last minutes. Let's try to fix it. In terms of animation, before I like my two lights. Like we see the reflection here, reddish line, bluish line. But I need a third light here. Putting some music. Why is it doing that? I don't know if I should put more shadows. Nah. This makes the. Yeah, I don't like that. Maybe the shadow should be somewhere else. Yeah, I like it better now. Oh yes, much better. But man, that king, it's glitching. I don't like the fact my pieces are pretty far away and we don't really see them closely enough. But at the same time, I don't really know how to fix that because And by the way, I'm gonna make it much slower than that. Like this rotation is pretty, it's pretty fast. So that's why usually I will put a T variable here and just, I can just globally change that. But for the development, it's pretty great because you can quickly test your thing and rotate it. In my case, so what should I do about that? Sinus, cosinus, it can grow. Something like that will help, but then I think we can go down and zoom and then back up and unzoom. So we have like a zoom factor. And to me that zoom is like literally like that. Then we need to, when zooming it's going down, yeah. And zoom when it's one, it's unzoom in fact. Zoom out. Let's call it Z. It's like the zooming out. So when it's zoom out, I want to increase. So this is like the craziest version. It's going to zoom a lot, but that's not what I want. I don't want to zoom at that. That's a bit dumb. I don't know what I can do though. Yeah, I like that. But then unzooming. Distance. Yeah, so we can see the pieces, but now I don't like my centering. I want to center on my white pieces when it's zooming in. So let's call that the point of interest. All right, so zero is definitely gonna stay. Same for Y, except I think I can add a bit. And the Z is going to be minus, probably that. It's pretty weird motion. I think I need to jump fast when it's unzooming. I don't know if this is doing anything great. I mean, we have to imagine it's gonna be much slower, and I think this can be also even slower. I don't really see why. Okay. All right, so. All right, so let's say we are at 5 and then we remove 3 times Z. So when it's unzooming, we are going down. The zoom. I think this is not the way I want. This is an unzoom. So when it's unzoom, actually I want that. I think we can increase that as well, but maybe a bit less. I don't get it. I mean, it's great, but I don't really feel it. It's weird. It's a weird motion. Yeah, that's great. But now, why is it doing that? I think I can offset this a bit. Alright, I think it's pretty great, and if I slow it down indeed, it's gonna be a bit better, but I need to change T here. Then we have more time to look at details. I spend the time I wanted to to use to tweak the king, but I mean, it's a game, it's part of the game to me. We should stick in 2 hours, so it's just the end of our 2 hours, and I think we are good. We can call that a chessboard. I don't know what we can call that. Time in here, it's a what do you call that? A chessboard? Starter? Chess start? Chess set? Chess set, and that's it. We have our shader of the day. Alright, so there were no one watching, I think. But I'm gonna publish that on YouTube anyway, and it's a bit for me, still live streaming, challenging a bit myself, trying to achieve something. It's okay if no one is watching, it's Christmas, everyone should enjoy Christmas anyway. And I guess we are good. And ending with a nice song like that, it's just like perfect. And we have nice lighting by the way, when it's with the reflection. It's not reflection, it's actually specular. We can increase a bit the specular for the board. Maybe that gives even better effect. Yeah, I like it. It looks great. Looks really great, like that. And except with a glitch. I don't know about the background, by the way. Like, should we keep it white? I think it makes sense. Actually, it's not really white. Let's see what happens. No, it's not great, but 0.7. Actually, you know what could be maybe fun to try is to mix between two values based on the P dot Y. RGB. I mean, yeah, it's. I'm not sure about that idea, but maybe if it's white, like before, and then I don't know if the camera is really gonna see anything, but yeah, it's a bit bluish. Okay, I think it's not enough dark anyway. Maybe the camera is not going down enough. I would like to keep that, but maybe more gray. I mean, we can use a light like a box, a cube, a sky. How do you call it? Sky box. What's the way you would solve it? To have a nice environment with some blur. I don't know what to do, to be honest. Like, this is not easy to tweak. But I don't like that. In a way, it's great because it gives some contrast with the white pieces. Ah, it's great. This one is great. I think I need to. I'm not sure. Should I do that? Or should I do that? It's better now. That or like, yeah. Oh, I was not doing the correct thing here. No, we don't see it. All right, we see it here. It's great. much more. It's nice. It does not appear so often. So that gives some unique part of the animation that gives some unicity, some exception, I would say. Yeah. All right. I think we are good. We are good. Just gonna put back the 0.2 animation. Record that and that's it. We have our shader. All right. So I think we are good, guys. Have a good evening and have fun if you write some shaders as well. See you next Saturday and have a good fest, good holidays, and take care, stay safe. Bye.